getting situated, and then we'll play. So we'll get everything kind of situated on stage the way you like it. Mental picture of where you are, and so and just take your time after the jazz. It should kind of be pretty close, you know, the setup. So, but kind of spread out, and figure it out, maybe kind of. Kind of like the idea of you standing. How do you feel about standing during the concert? It's usually sit, don't you? Yeah.
I can stand.
Yeah, we'll have you a mic.
Because I have my neck strap, so it wouldn't matter.
That's nice if you too stood.
Okay.
How do you feel about standing?
I'll just do this. The Benny Goodman.
Singular.
Singular.
Yeah, trumpet. But we'll run all that on Wednesday. And it's all black. I think everybody's black belt, black shoes, black socks.
I'm a black belt.
Any accoutrements, make a black, maybe wear a tie, jacket, you know, feather boa, as long as it's black.
A what?
Look, let's not do that. Well, I said I feather boa. I made a joke.
I don't know what that is.
It's like a.
What?
Like a big scarf? Oh. I don't know.
Yeah, it's like a feathered scarf. I doubt you have one.
I don't even know what it is.
I know something. I know one time
we got in trouble years ago. There was a concert.
Can you lower it?
What?
Can't see you to play one skill issue. And somebody wore pink cowboy hat. Kids, pink cowboy hat. Drummer from one of the regions saw it and got upset with our director. He instituted a strict all black policy after that.
Yeah.
Did understand that these are musicians.
Yeah, to me it wasn't my group, but he worked like one song.
I think it wasn't one of the pink hats for fashion recently.
When that guy wore pink socks in steel band.
So you know,
remember that?
No, I'm not in steel band.
I'm not trying to squelch anybody's individuality, you know. But
conform.
For this, just go all black.
The black cowboy hat.
It'll pay off in the future.
Your tinkles.
You play in any other musical groups, that's kind of a de facto uniform these days. You know, it used to be like, well, symphonies, I guess, are still tuxedos. Like a wind ensemble, stuff like that.
Tuxedos, sure.
You're all black. And, you know, social gig, whatever.
Yeah.
All right, let's do Little Moss.
I had a dream I was playing
Saxophone. Ready to go?
And then I chipped my reed. And I didn't have any other reeds, so I just stopped.
You need to be able to all the way through this. We got Oleg first, and then Grayson.
Oh, because we're doing
that. And then, kind of
that way. Oh, wait, we're doing that one.
This one, right?
The one more?
Because we always do it last, so we're going to do it first now.
One more time? Is it last? Thank you.
Right. So comping during the solos, I don't have it written down. They're kind of like.
What?
But because you guys can do contracts and things, we've talked about.
We'll find out.
David kind of doing.
I have to finish.
He can kind of do some organ stuff, but you know, you might think about, especially in 56, like during the A flat, B flat, G flat, doing more kind of sustained pad-ish kind of stuff, you know? It's a little staccato on the other parts, right? Something. And then you know, maybe some longer chords or something.
We can split the chords between.
Yeah, I'm wondering, maybe John, you want to do like the first one.
You did the first one,
yeah. Yeah, let's pencil that in.
Squidward.
Yeah.
Actually, he doesn't.
He does.
No, he didn't play the clarinet.
You
don't know that.
It's
not a clarinet.
Cool.
You're actually diagonal. What could possibly do that for? 5 o'clock.
Yeah.
4:30.
Yeah. The one of the
five. I really like the guitar line, the counter line.
The 4:30 11.
The shout section is really cool. We could bring those up. I tell the guitar player to turn up.
Talking about from A minor 7. You want the same?
Oh. No. Like,
you want me to be loud?
What is it? Spar 70, 77 around there.
I don't know if you borrow it.
Well, it's during the shout section.
Yeah,
you got that
from the A minor. From the A minor.
Yeah, you can bring that out even more, yeah. Can I hear just rhythm section? I don't want to beat A1 to death, but that's a tough little part, you know.
Yeah, we can muff it up all in.
Yeah, I heard a little bit of it the first time and the second time.
Coming out of the shop,
our
eyes are over here, and then we go, we got that strange rhythm.
You know, a lot of this stuff is really just kind of keeping your head together form-wise, you know, not just letting your mind drift and kind of keeping your spot in the music. And I mean, it's tough sometimes, you know, using your ears and all that good stuff. But let's start it. I guess just start at the top. No horns. It's just really sexy. Thank you. It sounds almost out of tune, but I think it was just something wrong there.
Yeah, I really.
Because I heard you played it. You locked in. It's like, oh no, it's a secret tune. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's tough. It's a weird spread, you know, with her.
Yeah.
Is this better?
Let's just do that same tempo.
Cool.
You're just at 22, just guitar players. One, two, oh, one, two, and two, and four, five. Thank you. that sounded good.
What?
No, we don't.
Flugelhorn something. It's mambo.
Oh, yeah, okay. You have flugelhorn on that one.
Okay.
But cup mute trumpet on sophisticated.
Yeah.
And then everything else. More.
Grayson for our first soloist. John's comping. It's just John for soloist.
Phil again.
Thank you.
So if I start here, 7th of D flat minor, or D flat major, C, right? You got to jump around a little bit. Well, let's do 7 and 3s, so we have a nice 4th to move around, right? So the closest one here would be D flat and G flat, right? 7 to 3, up a half step, right? Natural, G natural. C minor. Now, this is where you kind of face, like, as an arranger or chord instrument. You want to use 7s and 3s, or 3s and 7s, right? You can invert it, right? You want to invert it to the closest one. So what's my closest to C minor? Think about your 3rd and 7th of C minor. E flat, right? So yeah, it's really close, right? If I go to E flat here, that's D flat here. So I kind of broke. Right? Mm-hmm. So we got 3 and 7 now. And then now we can just go, up a whole step. Keep that same thing. What about B flat minor? They're not really related in any way, you know, they just move around nicely, these roots. Is it closer to go to the 3rd or 7th? Or does it matter? You can just keep it parallel. Because your 3rd is what?
D.
Mm-hmm. Now, the next chord, you can make a case. I can make a case for going maybe down here to the D flat, A flat. Go to the 3rd and 7th, right? Because it's just keep those parallel motion. Mm-hmm. And then here, if I wanted to go to the 3rd and 7th of A7, what's closest? The 3rd and 7th.
You're on.
Yeah. So if we just inharmonically, this is wrong. C sharp, and then you got the G, right? So that's the neat thing about these two chords. It's just really the root is different, but the 3rd and 7th, there's only a half step difference, right? Can you play that, Thomas? Play B flat in your left hand, and D flat and A flat in your right hand, right? And then A in your left hand to the two chords that look completely unrelated. You know, the minor chord to that dominant chord. This is a Wayne Shorter harmonic feature. He likes to do this a lot. Go from a minor chord to a major chord or a different chord that's half, like really only a half step away in harmonically.
Is there a word for that?
Wayne Shorterism. I'm sure there probably is a theorist's word, but you know, I don't know. I think it's kind of something. Sure, it comes from classical music. Somewhere. Yeah.
There is a tritone sub three flat.
Yeah.
So basically, it's just, you know, 1/4.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's a good point.
You can play,
this is a substitute for E flat 7.
Which means you can play an E flat major.
Solo E flat. A flat major, but
E flat there.
E flat dominant, yeah. E flat mixolydian.
Yeah,
E flat.
Yeah.
You kind of got to watch the C natural. It's not super clean, but it's, yeah. But yeah, that's a good point. But, you know, this is what we need to, as chord players, get through, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'm still hearing a little, yeah, on the soloing, a little struggle. You know, how do you contend with that as a soloist? You know, the chords have changed that quickly. You know, how do you practice?
Simplify it as much as possible.
Yeah, you know, I think, what do you say? Metronome, yeah, well, that's a given. But yes, you're right. Yeah, arpeggiate them, try to find other common tones, you know. And you're going to be in trouble here because usually when you have a half step movement, there's not any common tones, right? But this is the kind of the last frontier of the songs, yeah, getting through this little bit.
Right.
Yeah, like I hear John, like, it sounds great, you know, then it's just a little bit of...
did a little wood shedding and got them out.
Little nebulous through here, you know. But I think the thirds and sevenths, if you can kind of, you know, bass a solo, you know, you could, you know, try to bring this melodic line out. F, D flat, D flat, F, G flat, G, B flat, C, A flat, you know, you can bring that little counter melody out, right? Those thirds and sevenths provide a nice counter melody. That makes sense?
Mm-hmm. Thomas, let me play for a second. See if I can finish
it. Jazz. John, make some jazz. No.
So, I'm soloing for that section. Very common, like the sharp four walking down. It's a device used by like Cole Porter and Night and Day and quite a few others, like where you start with, if you think about this in E flat, you know, you start with sharp four, you start with E five, so you know, sharp four, seven, three, six, three, five, about it, right? Yeah. It's like a little pattern to it, right? Let's let me just hear the comping. Just really set it to the top. everybody play four. I want to hear everybody play four. One, two,
just do the blue.
Thank you.
hard drive by Big Phil. Well, let's go back to John. John's, I don't think we were quite at the B flat, right? I went to the B flat. We weren't quite there, right?
That was the fill for the B flat.
That's what I thought. I didn't.
Yeah.
I got a bunch of looks, so I'll make it sure.
Don't look at it.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Cool.
Four.
That's what I thought. Okay. We were right. Let's start back on John's all. One, two. Nice. I've been listening to Shohei and he's doing a great job of delineating the form. There's a lot to remember. You have a question, John?
Yeah, why don't we, the phrase just before the code, before we changed it to the Montuno,
mm-hmm.
and now we're leaving it out. Was that by, I don't remember you specifically saying leave out the bars before the DS.
Yeah, I just like to go straight to it.
Okay. Because it seems a little loose there. It seems like the, I don't know, maybe that phrase kind of gets us back into the rhythm, but
to get us back into
the strain of the melody.
I like it. I like heavy hitting the melody. I feel like we played that phrase enough. I mean, I don't have this. I just like going straight back in the melody.
I just want to know if, yeah, like purposely.
It's on purpose. Yeah. It's on purpose. I just, you know.
I mean, I knew we were working on it.
Yeah. Let's. Don't play.
Okay.
Just come in. I think what needs to happen is come in with the melody a little bit stronger. And I felt like the coda, maybe not everybody was.
I feel like there needs to be more sustained guitar or piano chords.
On the coda?
Play the minor major 7.
Yeah.
You know, really
Yeah, I'm for that. So, let's do it from the end of the Montego. It always sounds a little nebulous. We can pull back just a little bit, but I don't want to start. But let's start the Montego and drum solo and practice getting back in. Just come in really strong with the melody at the DS. So he's doing nice. And he can count us off that time, which is nice. But he picked up all. Yeah. We're all listening. We all know where to come in, right?
Probably.
Cool. Yeah, that was nice and strong. Yeah. I kind of jumped the gun a little bit. Cool.
I'm trying to get in tune. Makes it super
sharp.
Be in tune.
I don't think it was me, though. Because I'm in tune.
No, we were both out of tune, but I got way faster than you. You were doing it. Some scrap.
I want some scrap. Sounds good. Wait, what do you know? Have you heard scrap? Yeah? Yeah.
It's good.
Thank you.
play it completely perfect.
What if we just play something else at the end?
What's that?
Yeah, the horn player is just not played.
We'll play different notes.
Yeah, I think everybody's playing like the 11th, right?
Mm-hmm.
The sharp 11th.
Like maybe redistribute the chord.
Are playing like a B concert? What do you play, Kelsey?
We'll play a different note.
Yeah.
What's the chord?
Let's try playing. It's an F7 concert with a sharp 11. I don't want to make this play the F, but that might be the best.
I could do the third or fifth.
Can everybody play their F concert? You're already playing it.
F concert. Yes, E flat.
Yeah.
No wait, is it? I don't know anymore.
It's G.
Play a G.
Okay.
Can I play a B?
Yeah,
same thing.
Play
I could do a B or D or whatever.
Why don't you play the third? Why don't you play a B? Remember that note? Let's place it. 97. See how that sounds. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
What if I did the D instead? Instead of a B?
The which one?
The D? Like my fifth?
What about, what'd you do it?
The C sharp?
What'd you do it? Yeah,
just the
C
note.
Sharp or an F.
Okay.
Try an F, that would be the seventh. But you gotta keep it in range though.
Don't be bad.
I mean, it is in range.
You play an F down octave. Everybody play the same notes, everything else. So we've got G, F sharp, C sharp, right? Ready? Play. Yeah.
It's still missing something.
I'm trying to get the not to play, but you play C sharp.
You still made play an F. Do you want me to do the
C sharp?
Okay.
Nothing on beat one. Somebody play on beat one.
I would never do
that. 97. 1, 2.
Sounds weird. Are you playing a G? That's my wife. I'm going to play it
right now. We're sitting next to her.
But then you'll be in my range if you do that. Because I'm playing up there.
So I'm going to play the last note or
so
play your note?
The last measure should look like this.
Oh, well, you said you're going to play up there.
But I haven't been.
Okay.
And you don't have to play it, John. If you want to play the last one, it's kind of awkward. So. Should be rest.
Go even higher. Do the set of choir vanguard.
I never play to do that.
I don't see my set of choir vanguard. But like.
Well.
That under that G, I played once.
You can set it again.
Do it again.
Right?
I can't.
So that's the last measure.
Okay, let me
look at that later.
Da, da, da.
Yeah. So the last four bars.
So basically,
just gross. What we're doing is just tying.
Bruce and I did it, but it was like weird and squeaky.
No, it's all right. So this one just, we're adding on, just tie that into a quarter. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Bop, so you go. Bum, 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 up. Does that make sense? It's good class.
That was a
stronger. Cool.
All
right. Everybody got the notes, though. G, G, F sharp, A, right?
Yeah.
Cool.
A.
That should be, I think, a lot solid, more solid chord structure. Not so scary at the end. Get that rhythm pencil, man.